Hi everyone, welcome to the session on fluid machinery. Today we will be discussing few more numerical problems in connection with the reciprocating compressor. So we'll directly go to the problem. A single acting 14 cm by 10 cm. They haven't mentioned that whether it's a stroke length or bore diameter. So normally the procedure is first they will give the stroke length. Bore diameter, then we'll go for the stroke length. The first thing we have given, we have to take it as bore diameter, and second thing we have to take it as a stroke length if they haven't mentioned anything. So we'll be taking 40 cm as the bore diameter and the 10 cm as the stroke length of the given reciprocating compressor. Operating conditions are given: P1 1 bar, T1 20 degree Celsius, P2 6 bar, T2 180 degree Celsius, and the speed of the compressor is 1200 rpm. The shaft power is given as 6.25. The shaft power we required for calculating the mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency is the ratio between the power developed by the compressor. That is the equation. The power calculated by us using the equation. And the shaft power. So mechanical efficiency is the ratio between power developed by the compressor and shaft power. In the question they have asked for mechanical efficiency. That's why we need the value of shaft power. Okay. If the mass of air delivered is 1.7 kg per inch, the mass, unit of mass is kilogram, but they have given the mass as kilogram per inch. So they have already multiplied the mass with the RPM, that is some value 1200 by minutes. So they have given the value of RPM in given the value of mass in 1.7 kilogram per minute, so the already multiplied. So when we are substituting the value of this in our equation, that is for the equation for work done or for the equation of volume, we will be obtaining the answer as per minute or per second, whatever value we are substituting. If we are substituting the mass in kilogram per minute, we will be obtaining the work done equation as kilojoule per minute. Or we will obtain the volume equation as meter cube per minute. If we are substituting the mass equation in kilogram per second, we will obtain the work done equation as kilojoule per second. Or we will obtain the volume equation as meter cube per second. Okay. So normally we will be following either kilogram or kilogram per second. Okay. Calculate the actual volumetric efficiency. So volumetric efficiency we have to calculate. In the question, they have mentioned about the clearance volume. So we cannot conclude that it is a compressor without clearance volume. The reason is that they have asked for the volumetric efficiency in the question. Okay. As only if the compressor is with the clearance volume, there will be volumetric efficiency. So we have to assume that the compressor is with the clearance volume. Okay. The next thing we have to calculate the indicated power. That is the power developed by the compressor. We have the equation. The third one is the isothermal efficiency. It's a new term. Isothermal efficiency is the ratio between isothermal power and actual power. Actual power means power developed by the compressor, which is given by our previous equation. And isothermal power, we have already derived the equation for isothermal power. Use the equation for isothermal power and calculate the value of isothermal efficiency. The mechanical efficiency, know the equation. Power developed by shaft power, you will get the mechanical efficiency. And the last one, overall efficiency, is the product of volumetric efficiency, isothermal efficiency and mechanical efficiency. Okay. So we will go through the given data. Capital D, stroke length, P1, T1, P2, T2 and shaft power and mass. They have converted the mass into kilogram per second by dividing the thing with 60. Okay, to convert minute to second, we will be divided by 60. Okay, and first thing we have to calculate the volumetric efficiency. Volumetric efficiency, we got two equations. One is the actual volume by subt volume, and second thing is 1 plus C minus C into P2 by P1. As the C, value of C, that is clearance ratio, is not given in the question, we cannot use that equation. So we will be dealing with the volumetric efficiency, basically VA by VS. So VS is the subt volume. As they have given the diameter and stroke length, we can directly calculate the value of safety volume, so which is given by pi by 4 d square into L. And the next thing, we have to calculate the VA. So VA is not given in the question, but they have given P1 and T1 in the question. So using the question PV is equal to MRT, or P1 into VA, we will be dealing with the actual volume. We are not dealing with the intake total volume. V1 is total volume. Total volume given by safety volume plus clearance volume. We are not dealing with that. We are dealing with the actual volume only. So P1 into VA can be written as M into R into T1, from which we can calculate the value of VA. P1 is known, M is known, R is known, T1 is known. So substituting the value of VA in the volumetric efficiency equation, we will get the value of volumetric efficiency. Next thing, we have to calculate the indicated power. So we got the equation N by N minus 1 P1 VA. We have A already calculated, P2 by P1. All values are known to us. And one value is missing. That is N. They haven't given the value of N in this question. So we'll be using the equation for relation between pressure and temperature. T2 by T1 equal to P2 by P1 all raised to N minus 1 by N. So we know the value of T1 and T2. We know the value of P1 and P2. The only unknown is N. So substitute the value. So we'll get the in terms of power. Okay. To obtain the value of N, we have to take the log. Log of this side equal to N by N, N minus 1 by N into log of this side. So you will get the value of N by solving that. And the next thing, we are going to calculate the isothermal efficiency, which is given by isothermal work by actual work, where isothermal work is equal to MRT into P2 by P1, or P1 V1 into P2 by P1. P1 VA into P2 by P1, or MRT V1 into P2 by P1. So taking the ratio, we will get the value of isothermal efficiency. And the next thing, mechanical efficiency, W, that we have calculated here. The actual work done by shaft work will give us the mechanical efficiency. And the last one, overall efficiency, which is a product of volumetric efficiency, isometric efficiency, and the mechanical efficiency. Okay. We'll go through the solutions. These are the given data. First, we'll calculate the value of VA. PV is equal to MRT, P1 into VA is equal to MRT1. So as we are substituting the value of mass, we are substituting the value of mass in kilogram per second, we will obtain the value of VA in meter cube per second. As we are substituting the value of mass in kilogram, we will be obtaining the value of V in meter cube. If it is in kilogram per minute, we will be obtaining as meter cube per minute. Okay, so we got the value of VA, so we can calculate the value of VS. So VS can be calculated as pi by 4 d square into L. So normally the value unit of VS is equal to meter cube. As we are comparing the ratio of VA and VS, and VA we already got in terms of meter cube per second, we will be converting VS into meter cube per second by multiplying by N by 60. Okay. So multiplying by N is given as 1200 RPM. So N by 60, we will be obtaining the value of VS as again meter cube per second. So we will be taking off VA by VS, we will get the value of volumetric efficiency 0.77, and converting it into percentage, we will be obtaining the percentage as 77.92%. That is the first thing we have to calculate. The second thing we have to calculate the work done, where N by N minus 1, P1 VA, P2 by P1 all raised to N minus 1 by N. P1 is given, VA we have already calculated here, 0.24, and P2, P1, that's all known, only unknown is N. So calculating then, we are comparing the relation between pressure and temperature. T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 all raised to N minus 1. So we have got the value for T3 by 293 equal to 600 by 100 all raised to N minus 1 by N. Taking log on both sides, and finding the value of N as 1.32. So, got the value of N. Substituting the value of N in the equation for work done, so we'll get the work done as 5.39. As we have substituted the value of VA. We have VA substituted in meter cube per second. So we will be obtaining kilojoule per second, or we are writing as kilowatt. This is our required power. The next thing we will be calculating the isothermal efficiency. Isothermal efficiency is given by the ratio between isothermal work and actual work. For isothermal work, we got the equation MRT1 into P2 by P1. So M is given, R we are 0.287, and temperature is given T1, and natural logarithm of, so one ln is missing, sorry, 600 by 100 is 4.26 kilowatt. It's the isothermal work done. The next thing, isothermal efficiency, comparing the value of actual work, that is 5.39 in the denominator, and isothermal work in the numerator. Normally, actual work will be less than the isothermal work for normal machines. But for compressor, it is opposite. Actual work is greater than the isothermal work. Why? As the compressor is doing the work, suppose the compressor want to increase the work from 1 bar to 2 bar. So, increase the pressure from 1 bar to 2 bar. So, in ideal case, the compressor is not considering any friction and all. They have to apply minimum power to increase the pressure from 1 bar to 2 bar. But when coming to actual case, the situation may different. So, the compressor has to work more to obtain the same pressure ratio. That's why actual work is more than in case of compressor. So this work done by the compressor. So in such machines, the actual work will be more than the ideal work. Ideal work will be less, actual work will be more. Okay. Next thing, we'll calculate the mechanical efficiency, which is the ratio between the actual work by shaft work. The compressor will be running with the help of a motor. The power of the motor is called shaft work. So whatever the power given by the motor cannot be converted into compressor work. Some there will be some loss, and that loss is called mechanical loss. So the efficiency between that is called mechanical efficiency, which is given by 86.2%. And the last thing will be calculating the overall efficiency, which is a product of volumetric efficiency, isothermal efficiency, and the mechanical efficiency. So we have already calculated all three efficiencies. Multiply this value, you will get the value of overall efficiency as 53.09%. So by this, we have gone through normal questions of reciprocating compressor. If we get time, we will be discussing more problems in the coming classes. Okay, thank you.